Welcome to WatchGuard's Daily Security Byte. I'm Corey Nachreiner. Today's story is Bitfi Pwned. Today's Friday story is not really anything about practical tips, more tongue-in-cheek fun, because a Bitcoin wallet that John McAfee backs was hacked. You probably know John McAfee. He's the CEO that actually headed up the McAfee company a long time ago. But since then, he's been known as this weird eccentric guy that takes too many drugs and allegedly might have murdered somebody in Belize. He's been posting lots of crazy videos, and he also backs this particular Bitcoin wallet called Bitfi. And about a week or so ago, he claimed that this Bitcoin wallet was unhackable. But about a week after that, a Dutch researcher did hack it. He gained root on the Bitcoin wallet and had this root access while the wallet was still connecting online. And in fact, he didn't have to pay any money for the hardware necessary for this wallet to actually hack it, which is a big deal in itself. Now, the CEO of Bitfi is apparently saying that they're offering a $250,000 bug bounty for anyone that finds flaws in their actual Bitfi wallet. But the truth is, the Dutch researcher says that's all marketing fluff, that they're not really going to pay out that particular bug bounty because he has found a root vulnerability. So I just think it's an interesting story, especially because it's associated with John McAfee. If there's anything to learn from this, it's that nothing is unhackable, and anyone that says something is unhackable is crazy. In fact, this is kind of old news. In the 2000s, Oracle had this big campaign called Unbreakable, claiming their software was unbreakable or unhackable too. But then shortly after, another security researcher, well-known guy named David Lynchfield, really found over and over and over again many root code execution vulnerabilities in Oracle products as well. So there are some products that are more secure than others, but you should never consider anything unhackable. Now, having said this, it will be interesting to see if John McAfee ever responds to this and releases another crazy video just because they're fun to watch. Now, with that story done, there's one other excuse for me doing this Friday video, and that's to warn you there's probably going to be less videos next week, which hasn't been unusual with my latest schedule, but it's more because we're attending the Black Hat DEF CON security conferences. And the good news is, even though there might be less videos, we do guarantee at least two or three videos specifically to recap what we're seeing at these great security conferences. For at least two or three days, Mark and I will recap some of the talks we've seen either at Black Hat or DEF CON. So I recommend you keep an eye on this channel just to see some of the interesting talks that we hear about. On top of that, for the past year or so, the WatchGuard Threat Lab has been taking part in the fun by participating in what's a DEF CON style CTF or Capture the Flag badge challenge. These are really kind of puzzle challenges or hacking challenges that are often related to digital badges. And these digital badges are often part of the challenge, something that you need to solve many of the puzzles in the challenge. So I'm very proud that our WatchGuard Threat Lab has a cool badge for this challenge. In fact, if you're at Black Hat DEF CON, come find us, either the WatchGuard booth at Black Hat or me or Mark anywhere at DEF CON, because you can get one of these badges free and participate in our CTF challenge. In fact, if you win, you might be able to win a free 3D printer or a drone. And I'm very proud again of the threat team for making such a cool badge, as well as one of our interns, Zane Young, who did all the hardware hacking and software coding work on this particular badge. Very cool. I recommend you come check it out. Anyways, that's it for today's story. Thank you for watching.